I welcome back to the presentation on analysis of determinate structures. In the last presentation, we had seen some basic concepts or introduction connected with analysis of determinate structures. We had talked about different types of loads that is acting on the structure, objectives of structural analysis, and the most important thing, what exactly we try to do in structural analysis, that is to find the internal forces in various members of the structural system, and also to find the deformation in various members of the structural system. An important thing that we need to remember is, in case of two-dimensional structures, that is plane structures, the maximum number of internal forces that we can have in any member is 3, and the maximum number of deformations we can have is again 3. If you just try to look at the beam problem, we had discussed that we have only 2 internal forces present in the beams, that is the shear force and the bending moment. The axial force is very small and we normally ignore that. Regarding the deformations, we would be more interested to calculate the vertical translation, that is movement, okay, and the rotations. In case of truss problems, the only internal force we have is an axial force. We don't have bending moments and shear force. And axial force can be of tension type or compression type. As you already have seen, some members are in compression, some members are in tension. Coming to the deformation in truss, we have only 2 translations, because rotations are not held, it is permitted. So we are talking about computing only 2 translations, that is X translation and Y translation in trusses. Coming to the arch problem, we have said that all the 3 internal forces are present and you will be trying to compute them, that is the axial force defined as normal thrust in this case, the shear force defined as radial shear, and the bending moment. So all 3 internal forces exist in arches and you will be computing that. However, the deformations, though all 3 are present, 2 translations and rotations, we are not attempting to calculate in this course. And in case of cables, very flexible members, so we have only tension in these cables. There is an axial force, we don't have even a compressive force over there, so the problem is much simpler here. Coming to the deformations, we have only translations X and Y, but we are not trying to compute in this course. Now, coming to the discussion that we are trying to have here, okay, so some of the learning outcomes, okay, that we are trying to have here are in this particular course, we would be trying to calculate some informations with respect to the problem in the slide. Okay, Sitaram, next slide over there. Okay, there seems to be some problem. Okay, so I will be trying to continue the discussion. Okay, yeah, so we have coming to the learning outcomes. Okay, so we have the we will be discussing some structural forms here, the equilibrium equations, determinate and indeterminate structures, compatibility conditions, linear and non-linear analysis, the degrees of freedom and degree of static indeterminacy. So these are some of the topics that I would be trying to cover in this particular class. So the first one is the structural forms. Generally, we can have different shapes. Forms is nothing but shapes for structures. I'm just trying to take you through some interesting forms that we see in structural analysis. Now we just try to look at the picture. What you are trying to see is the famous Taj Mahal. We have a huge dome over there. Okay, and if I'm correct, the size of the dome is, the diameter of that is close to 20 meters. So we just try to look at another interesting structure. That is nothing but the Gol Gumbaz. So the diameter of the dome is close to 40 meters. So these are some interesting forms that you can see in civil engineering structures. So it's quite massive. Now there are other types of domes also. So this is one more interesting historical importance dome. This is in Italy. That is, it's the Pantheon structure, a huge dome. If I am correct, it is almost 45 meters, close to 45 meters, the world's largest dome built. So 45 is quite big. So what you need to understand here is the kind of forces, okay, that are present in the thickness of that dome and how exactly one needs to calculate all those things. Now, an interesting dome that you normally see across in modern world is the geodesic domes. Okay, so they can be built for diameters varying from 5 meters to 40 meters. So this is one form or shape, okay, that you can try to see in case of structural system. Now another form that we can think of is a vault. As you see a typical picture, normally it is supported on four columns, okay, and the shape is quite interesting over here. So this is built in, especially in ancient structures. So one of the pictures that you can see here is, okay, a structure made up of series of vaults. Looks very, very interesting. So again, the important concept that you need to analyze here is how the forces flow to the columns, okay, from these vaults. So the analysis is very interesting. Now the other interesting forms that I can try to tell you is the shells. Most of the modern structures you see have shells of different types, interesting shapes. So this is one of the shells that you can clearly see in one of the airports. The spans are huge, okay, and it can be designed, okay, to for any span. So the shape is quite stable here. Now another old structure that you have is, okay, the Nervi Stadium, and this probably was built in early 70s. So again, you can clearly see combinations of, okay, shell structure followed by, okay, the inclined supporting system, okay, makes the structure quite interesting. So again, this is one more popular or famous structure, the Opera House in Australia, okay, wherein you can clearly see the shells being made in some particular fashion, okay, to match the caterpillar, okay. So that is how it's been conceived. Now this is our own structure in Delhi, okay, the Lotus Temple. So I would like to say that structures can be made of various forms, okay, and here also the size can be different. It can be made to interesting replicas of either the nature or the animals or whatever it is. So the shell structure is one very good feature or component, okay, that we can think of to give shapes, different shapes to the structures.